Start. Thank you very much for joining. It's always a great pleasure to welcome you in this monthly OpenAIRE Provide community calls. So we are running this community since September, October last year. The idea is to share recent developments and to share the services, the details of the services that OpenAIRE have for content providers. So it's always a pleasure to welcome you. We have different people in this call from managing different kinds of data sources of OpenAIRE and also part of the OpenAIRE community, the OpenAIRE network, National Open Access Desk. So it's a great pleasure to welcome you. As for all the other community calls, just to check if we are already recording. Okay, perfect. So we have always this first 3-4 minutes where we provide some updates, and this is what I am going to do in the coming minutes. And then usually we dedicate some more time, like 20 minutes, for a main topic for discussion. And today is on the users count service, our user statistics functionalities available in the dashboard and but beyond, because this is a service also available in other components of the OpenAIRE ecosystem. But we will focus today on what we have in the dashboard and why we have this service and how can you enable and use the data from this service. We will count with our colleague Dimitris, that is the manager of this service, technically speaking, and he will do a presentation. And then we have more time for questions and comments, not only about the users counts. Of course, the first part is dedicated to the users counts service, but then you can also address other issues related with other services or issues that you are encountering using the dashboard. So this is the time to use. So usually we dedicate 50 minutes to 1 hour at each call. And you feel free to put questions in the chat or to just unmute yourself and ask your questions. So I have four main informations to share with you. There are always lots of things that we can share, but one is good information, because unfortunately we were not able to put in production in November the new the developments that we are doing in our broker service. So we thought that we can do it until the end of November, but unfortunately we're not able. For sure before Christmas we have it. As soon as possible in December we want to have it. So other priorities we faced other priorities, and unfortunately we didn't dedicate the time to finalize. Our technical team didn't have the time to finalize what we need to finalize. So this in fact is already available in beta, but so we need to put it in production as soon as possible, and we hope to have novelties in the coming weeks for you. So if those that are not aware, so I'm just please be aware that we did one call entirely dedicated to this, the broker developments. We did it in early October, so the recordings are available, but basically, just for you, for those that are not aware, so I think it's important. As you know, we have the broker service running since two years in OpenAIRE, and the visible part of the broker service are the metadata enrichment events that we provide via the dashboard, and we realized that the way that we are delivering these events to the end users, to the repository managers via the dashboard, was not completely scalable for us in terms of the management of the infrastructure, and we realized that we should do some changes. The service is quite good and mature, but we have changed the way that we are delivering the metadata event. So just for you to know, some of you are already aware of that because you have participated in previous calls, but I just want to share this slide just for... So what we have changed is that we have now three phases, and until the second phase, we just deliver 100 events, metadata enrichment events, for you to be aware that we have relevant enrichments for you for the different categories of events that we have available. Links to projects, the abstracts, open access versions, the PIDs, so the different events that we have. We just create a sample. Okay, be aware that we have events for you. We can expose to you 100 or less, depending on the events that we have available for you. And then if you are interested in a specific event, in a specific type of event, category of event, you just go and create the subscription. And only after the creation of this subscription, we can deliver it for you. We will deliver for you all the events that we have available. It can be 200 or 2000, depending of each repository. But so we are not sending the total metadata enrichment events for you in advance without having your interest or not. So first we expose to you, okay, this is what we have to offer you. If you are interested in, for example, metadata missing PIDs or missing links to projects, you just subscribe, and then we are going to send you all the events related with that. We will notify you about that. So we are not sending you all the events if it's not necessary and relevant for you. So if you want, so for sure in the coming year we will have another call dedicated to this, and when it's in production, we will do a quick demo in the, I hope to have it in the first call of the year in January. But be aware that you can listening Claudio Azzori from CNRE3 presenting these changes in the broker event. So the other thing is that in the last 2 or 3 months is that there were at least 2 translations of the literature guidelines version 4. So it's available in our website, guidelines.openair.eu, the translation in Spanish. There is also a translation in Portuguese. So if you look into the website of our guidelines, guidelines.openair.eu, you'll see that we have guidelines in the version 4 in English and the in translation also in Spanish. And be aware that there is also our colleagues from IBICT, the Brazilian Institute of Information Science and Technology, also did a translation in the end of September, and they have it available in like a kind of publication in their repository. So be aware of that. So it's a Brazilian Portuguese translation. So if you want to know more about the guidelines and you want to do it in your own language, Spanish or Portuguese, you can do it already. Then a novelty about the users count service. So new infrastructure, workflows, the data from the statistics is already available in production. So almost all issues, the majority were fixed. Dimitris will talk about that later, but be aware of that. We only have some issues with some graphics that we are presenting in a minimal number of repositories. If you encounter graphics that they only have that until 2018, please contact us. But we are aware of that, and we will solve that in the coming days. But we have the list of repositories that have this issue. But all the data behind the queries and the reports that you can get, it's correct. Only the graphics, the visual part is not correct. But maybe Dimitris can add some more information about that during the presentation. Another thing, so we have decided that after the broker, this new way of delivering events, this update, the next update will be the new functionality, the multi-user access, something that you all are asking for to have since the beginning. Finally, we find time to do it. Basically, what we want to do, we are almost there. I have a slide here to share. So basically, the idea is that under the update tab of the dashboard, you will have a new menu, a new tab, update permissions, where basically what you can do is that you can invite more users to access and manage your data source. It's not your account, of course. It's not sharing the account. It's sharing is providing access to another account to manage the data source, the repository. For example, this case is a print screen of the University of Minho repository. So our manager, that is Ricardo will provide access to other persons to manage, and we don't need to share the login and the password. So we just invite others and we assign these permissions to others. This is something that lots of you maybe in this call and in different presentations have asked to have. So we are happy. So we have already checked all the requirements. So we have this prepared, and we hope to have this soon in one of the coming updates. For sure, we will have this new tab under update, and you can invite more users to access and to manage your data source. So these are the four highlights that I want to give in this first part. Now we will dedicate some time to the main topic of the session, and I will invite Dimitris. You can present yourself, Dimitris, and then run this presentation. We will have also a Mentimeter for you to collect some feedback. So stay active in the coming meetings, in the minutes also to come up with some feedback for us, because this is important. At the end, we will have questions. If you want to ask questions in the chat, you can do it during the presentation of Dimitris, but at the end, we will have time for questions. Also about these updates or about other things. So, Dimitris.
Thank you, Pedro. Let me share my screen.
And thank you. I see some more people that have joined, so thank you for those that have already joined. You can turn on your camera, or then for the questions and answers, also do it in using the microphone, because this is a community call, and this is good to see faces.
Okay, can you see my screen now?
Yes, perfect.
Yeah, thank you. So, hello. Let me welcome you also to in the 10th community call of OpenAIRE. The main topic is about the users count service, which is one of the services offered by the OpenAIRE ecosystem. I'm Dimitris Pierakos. I work for Athena Research Center, and together with my colleague, my colleagues from University of Bilfert, Andrea Czesniak and Jorge Sirvangin, we have developed the usage count service of OpenAIRE. The usage count service is actually the service that measures the engagement and the impact of this engagement to the content offered by OpenAIRE. And I will explain in detail what this is all about during this presentation. Before that, I would like to ask you, just for a warm-up, to participate in this Mentimeter questions. You can go to this link and use this code. We have created some questions there. As you know, Andre, will you share your screen?
Yes, I will start to share my screen and share.
Okay, thank you.
The Mentimeter results. Okay. I think you are seeing my screen.
Okay, first of all, I would like to ask you if you are using any kind of a user statistics service. We have a draw. No. Okay, so 8 out of 50 people don't use any user statistics service at all. Okay, can we go to the next question? So that makes our presentation very interesting because the majority doesn't know the service at all or knows about the service but hasn't registered yet. Okay. And then last one. So if you ever use the, for those who have used some kind of a use statistics service, which issues have you identified? Privacy, technical issues, standardization, accuracy? Don't care too much, okay. So your main concern is standardization, then accuracy. And then accuracy, okay. And you don't actually care too much, okay. That's fine. That's fine, okay, thank you. Thank you, these are the questions, so I can go on with my...
Yeah, excellent contributions.
Yeah, true. Yeah. So after this warm up, let's proceed with presentation. These are the topics that will be discussed. I will provide an introduction to the service, which I will try not to extend it with a lot of technical details. I will focus mainly on the most attractive part, which is what you can get from the service and how can you get it, what are the interfaces and the tools that we offer and that could be used to get interesting analytics from the service. And I will also present how can you participate, how you can register and be a member of this service. So you can have access to hopefully all these interesting stuff that will be shown today. So first of all, where does user account service is placed inside OpenAIRE's infrastructure, inside OpenAIRE ecosystem? As you may know, OpenAIRE simply collects research content from content providers like institutional repositories, aggregators, data archives and a lot of other types of content providers. And a set of OpenAIRE services is applied to this content, for example, the duplication, harvesting, mining, and the final outcome is the OpenAIRE Research Graph. The main entity of the OpenAIRE Research Graph is the research project, which could be a publication, a project, an organization, a data set, etc. And what the usage count service actually does. It measures, it simply counts the usage of these research products across content providers. In other words, it measures how many times a particular research product is accessed, and this access refers to either metadata views or downloads of this research product. And after finishing with accounting, the service produces statistics, user statistics, about the performance of the product, the usage of the product, not only inside a certain content provider, but also across many content providers where this research product has been accessed. So this is more or less a description of of the placement, let's say, of OpenAIRE users account service inside OpenAIRE. So how we do it? What is the architecture that we have built, and what are the workflows that are used for the users account service? Well, we're following two approaches. The first one is called push, since users activity information is pushed directly to our analytics platforms and in real time. To achieve this, we have provided a set of tools in the form of plugins or scripts that could be installed or executed in case of a script at repository sites and send information directly to our analytics platform. The analytics platform that we use is the open source analytics platform, which is called Matomo. Maybe you are aware of it. This is our first approach. So we install or provide scripts, and we retrieve raw usage activity from content providers directly to our analytics platform. The second approach is called a pull approach, since we do not retrieve the actual raw usage activity, but we collect usage statistics in the form of reports that are prepared using standard schemes like the counter code of practice which is provided by Count Initiative. These reports are collected from aggregators like, for example, IRUS UK. So in both cases, either push or pull, following our these two approaches, information is stored in our statistics database, and is further processed and combined using information from other OpenAIRE research graph items in order to produce the user statistics for either the research product or the content provider, for example, an institutional repository. These user statistics are then published in OpenAIRE portal infrastructures like Explorer Provide, or they are available using open APIs following the SUSE Lite protocol. I will describe this later. So this is more or less our architecture and the workflows. Just remember that we are following two approaches: the push to collect directly usage activity, and the pull to collect already available standardized reports. This is a rather technical slide, just to inform you that we are our main infrastructure based on Hive and Impala. We have moved from the old infrastructure, which was in a PostgreSQL database, and for an analytics platform, we are using the Matomo open source analytics. Just to summarize the usage count service features, we follow two approaches. For tracking the usage, we call it push, and collecting counter reports, standardized reports, we follow the pull approach. All information that's collected is anonymized, so we keep we preserve users' privacy, and we anonymize the IP addresses of all users' activity that's collected. By exploiting the metadata deduplication service offered by OpenAIRE, we are able to accumulate usage for the same research outputs. I will provide a certain example later in this talk. And finally, because most of you are worried about the standardization, we produce counter code of practice compatible reports. These are standards-based user statistics, and this allows us to compare our statistics, the statistics that we produce, with statistics from other data sources. So just keep in mind that in terms of standardization, we are compatible with counter code of practice, which is now offered in which now support release 4, and in the next version, we will support also counter code of practice release 5. So keep in mind that usage counts is a measure of scholar impact. We measure the engagement of research products. We simply count and we produce results about how a particular research product is used. And since impact is number, let's see some numbers. So if you go to the provide dashboard, OpenAIRE Content Provider Dashboard, you can see the performance in terms of usage activity of a certain repository. For example, Yumino, you can see the number of views and the downloads. And this is the graph that shows the evolution of this service for this particular repository. This is the graph that Pedro mentioned that has issues, and the statistics are displayed only until 2018, although we have collected information until last October. This is will be solved in the next days. And as a content provider, as a repository manager, you can also use this interface to ask to retrieve reports specific for a period of time for your repository using this interface, which is provided by Content Provide the dashboard. You can also see this the same information in the other portal of the other interface provided by OpenAIRE in the Explore portal, where you can see the same numbers for this repository, and you can check it in the explore.openair.edu. This is not only for repository management, but is public. You can see the performance of other repositories there. Another important thing is that in Explore, you can see the performance, the user statistics for a particular product, research product, for example, a publication. You can see that this publication has been has 167 accesses, total user statistics. From these statistics, 82 are downloads and 84 are total views, and one are OpenAIRE. One is OpenAIRE views, but the most important part in this for this item is that aggregation of this number. So the 82 downloads and the 84 views have been aggregated for more than one repository. So we have this information and will be displayed in the next version of the Explore. You can check it in this slide. You can see that the 82 downloads have come from two different repositories, and the 84 views have also come from two different repositories. So this information is important, and we can have it using by exploiting the duplication service offered by OpenAIRE Research Graph. Apart from the general services portals of OpenAIRE for the provide and explore, we have recently developed a portal dedicated to the user count service, where you can find a lot of information about the usage count service, such as the architecture, the various resources that are offered for this service. You can also we can also provide have contact forms where you can ask us about the service. And most importantly, we have numbers, we have analytics, and we have analytics like the total number of user statistics that we have in our databases, the total number of repositories, and the total number of user downloads that we have collected so far worldwide. And you can set for user statistics for a particular country. For example, for Spain, you can have the repositories and the views and downloads for this particular European country. And we also offer reports for countries outside Europe, from, for example, Argentina. Because we have collected also statistics for La Referencia, the national South America aggregator, Latin America aggregators. In this portal, you can also see the evolution of OpenAIRE user statistics service. You can see we have started with a few statistics, and now we are evolving too fast, and we are collecting and producing a large number of views and downloads. Apart from these interfaces, you can also exploit the usage counts OpenAIRE.eu user statistics API. It is based on the SUSE Lite protocol, and from there you can retrieve again counter code of practice release for compatible reports, standardized reports. You can have article reports, book reports, item reports like using identifiers like OpenAIRE ID, DOIs, OAI record IDs, etc. You can have a repository report using identifiers issued by OpenAIRE or OpenDoor, or general reports using identifiers like ISSN. This is an example of a report that you could get by using this API. You can, on the left, you can see a repository report, and on the right, you can see a report that is retrieved by using a particular item. One of our stakeholders could be a funder, so we can have information about funders. For example, you can see here the number of downloads for all funders that are using that we have collected in OpenAIRE. This is an important information if you are a funder, and we can provide similar analytics for other stakeholders. And now, how can you join this service? How can you participate? You can register via the provider's dashboard if you are a literature repository, data repository, journal, or aggregator. By registering the service, we will provide you with instructions to join the service. From your side, on your side, you have to download the tracking code for your repository. You have to configure according to the instructions that we provide, and then deploy the tracking. And from our side, we will validate the installation of the tracking code and inform the repository manager that everything is okay, and the service is up and running without any issues. By enabling the metrics for the selected data source, you will able to retrieve the software that I mentioned initially for the push approach, which is provided either as a patch for virus version of DSpace from DSpace 4 to DSpace 6, as an ePrint plugins for version 3, and most importantly, we have developed a Python script which can be used in any platform, in any other case. It can be used for DSpace and ePrints also, and they are available, and you can install it, you can run it, you can execute it easily, and send us any kind for any kind of usage activity from your repository. So about the future, we have to engage more research content providers to count more research products like research data, monographs, books, etc. We are planning to move to counter code of practice release 5. We try to offer more analytics, more enhanced visualization to cover more stakeholders, etc. And we try to build a usage counts hub that we combine and collect information from many research products, example publications with research data. So thank you very much for your attention. This is more or less the presentation of the service. And I'm ready to answer to your questions if there is any. Thank you.
Great, many thanks, Dimitris. So I think it was a very good presentation, clear. So we are aware of the features of the service, how it works, what we can offer, and how to enable. Registered in the service, can you clarify how many repositories have we already part of this service are benefiting from this service? Do you have the updated numbers?
yes, as mentioned, we have around 200 repositories that have using the service. This is a number that is shown that that can be accessed in usage-counts.openair.eu portal. If you go there, you will see the numbers for each country, for each and the worldwide in total.
Okay, thank you. So you can turn on your microphone or camera if you want and ask questions and try to clarify any specific issue. If you have any relevant topic that you need to, any issue problem with the dashboard, you can also put in the comments here. So we have already, in fact, some questions, okay, that I will...
We have one question in the chat and also in the Google Doc.
Okay, in the chat. I was checking the Google Doc. So thank you for that. I will share my screen also. So the question in the chat. Where is it? Yes, the chat.
Have you enabled the service, Jordan? Right.
Yes, the Jordan.
I have enabled the service to run AIRE. How can I? I think there is a button that allows you to retrieve the service, to retrieve the data. Sorry, from there. To at least.
What is the dub? So have enable. How can I download this data? The report. Okay.
Yes. I think that in provide openair.eu there is the functionality. There is a button that allows you to download the report. But I will check it.
Yes. Let me also do one. Then I can share. Okay, Jordan, we will demonstrate that, then we can address this issue. There are other questions here in the chat also. Let me share my screen. So thank you for those that have created. So Cristobal from Barcelona, can the OpenAIRE users account service track the users that come directly? Okay. Yes, this is an important question to the digital object PDF, for instance, from the Google Scholar. This is an important question, Cristobal, and we have a clear reply to that because we did a pilot in the past.
Yes. This is why we have used all these patches and plugins and the generic tracker, because we have to solve this issue. We had to solve this issue because a request arrives from Google Scholar to a repository using some client-based, let's say, code software, this request is not tracked. So that's why we are using this software, either by plugins or the generic tracker. And we count all any kind of request that is arriving in the repository. So we are not missing a thing. I hope I have answered your question. I have replied to your question.
Yeah, thank you very much. We have other questions here. I stopped sharing my screen without. Okay. Sorry, I stopped sharing the screen. I didn't realize I stopped. Okay, we have a question from Ellie. Thank you, Ellie, for your question from Dens from the Netherlands. Narcissus is a national aggregator being harvested by OpenAIRE. Can the user accounts be used by our different repository managers? Yeah, this is the same issue. It's not currently. The proper answer is no. It's possible if we do some further developments. It's not possible currently in what we have now. In fact, Dimitris, maybe you can clarify a bit the work that we are doing with La Referencia is in fact can be used by a national aggregator like Narcis, because La Referencia is the Latin America network of repositories. The data will be provided for the nodes, for the national nodes, for the national networks of repositories, and we will have data collected for La Referencia that then we can distribute for the individual repositories. And the type of approach that La Referencia is doing is something that we can also do in OpenAIRE if we have time and effort for that. Dimitris, do you have something to add?
Not something special, more specifically. I think we can follow a similar approach with our referencia, with any kind of national aggregator.
So for sure we can enable for Ellie. This is something that we can do quickly to enable this service. Maybe we can talk offline, so we can exchange some emails and we can enable this service for this specific aggregator. Then we will start collecting data. What is important is to collect data. Then we will find ways to deliver. The problem is deliver the data for the individual repository managers. This is not possible to do it now. Collect data from the aggregation, the aggregator itself. We can do it, but let's see what we can do for the individual repositories, because currently this is not feasible. But
yes, there are.
Yeah, but we need to put this in our because there are several issues for national aggregators that we need to address. Now.
Yes,
always the same.
For now, we have
need to IRUS. Have a reply for those issues.
For now, we have the IRUS, where we collect reports using the counter code of practice.
Yes, IRUS have a service for that.
Yes, and we have also La Referencia, where we collect from their aggregation system, let's say. But we have to find a solution. It's, as you mentioned, the problem is how to collect data.
So do you see the question from Biljana here?
Yes, you're right, Biljana. Just check it. And I think it has to do with the name. It's Serbia and Montenegro. I'm not sure what is. I will check it. I will check it with the developers of the portal. If you go to the analytics, yes, and search for the country. I will check if there is an issue. Mm-hmm. Yes, we will fix that, because it's the mm-hmm. Okay.
And just to make some note, if I choose the Serbian Montenegro, there is no result there, because
yes, that's what I replied just now. I think there is an issue with the string, the service in Montenegro. I will check it, but the statistics are there. Don't worry. It will be solved soon.
Thank you. And then, do you want to ask the other questions or to make a comment, Liana, as you have?
I'm really disappointed, because the things which are properly work last 2 or 3 years, and our special repository manager use all of these services a lot, and now they are just stopped working. Exactly, they are working, but not working properly. Let's say the monitor dashboard, I know my credentials, I see all my validation history, but now I could not find any of repositories. And I know there are 15 of them there.
In Provide, yes.
In the monitor, there are these three funders. We have it also for months before. We have all of them, all funders there. So this is my complaint that developing all things which were stable are not anymore.
Yes. In the monitor, I don't have an explanation for you. I think this was already presented by other people with responsibilities in OpenAIRE, that I think it was an error. It was a precipitation, I think. I'm with you. I was lucky because the information of the Portuguese funder was there, because it was the first pilot. But this is so it's not good to have it. For provide this table. Okay, let me check. Provide this table. We have an issue with your login. It's a login issue. It's not a service issue. Okay. I think I hope so. I think I can say that the provide this table, that we are increasing and providing more functionality since we have delivered the service first in September 2018. I think almost every semester we have introduced something new. But yes, you are right. So Andre, we really need to check why Brianna's login don't have access to the repositories. This is something that we need to talk with the three or four persons, because we didn't find yet the where is the issue. The issue is somewhere between any connector that we are not sure why. So AAI, so there was an update today from the AAI, the authentication service. So we need to check when we play with the in the same service in this dashboard for the case with different APIs, with different services, so we can encounter this kind of problems. Brianna, it's a promise that after this call, we will do our best to solve.
Good. There is no need to give a highest priority, but
this is important because we receive the same type of requests sometimes. So the usual problem is that repository managers don't find the data source in their login. But usually, the issue is that is related with previous registration. So someone registered that data source using another login, another email, and now we need to change it. But we usually solve it. We solve it in 1 hour or in 24 hours, so we can solve it quickly. But sometimes we have these issues with. Let's see. I'm not sure if some of my colleagues that are here in the call can help, but I don't think so. Thank you, Maurice. If you want also to talk about your use case, you can talk, but so you are in
I can
project
talk.
Mm-hmm.
So
thank you for putting the question here, because then we can provide more information here.
Sure. If I think maybe this might be too complex to answer, and we need to talk it offline. My use case is that I'm in a project with 11 universities. I need to collect publication data, but also I want to collect use statistics from them to see what the usage is, of course. But I'm not a provider of all each of these. So either I need to ask people to give me the CSV file or whatever that's been downloaded and put it into my collection, or maybe there is an easier way to do it with an API or something like that. I don't know.
Yes. The answer is yes. This should be possible using our API. We need to check if it's possible for all, because we need to check if we have as direct data sources, these repositories from these 11 universities, or other kinds of data sources from these 11 universities. Some of them may have, for example, journals or journal systems, these kind of things. But we need to check, so we can talk offline. I saw in the call someone from Barcelona. Let me check if he's here.
Maurice, sorry for
it. No, not it's not here. But for your knowledge, Maurice, I'm checking if I, so it's the Polytechnical University of Barcelona. They have a similar use case. So in fact, they did, but of course, it's only one university, but they have used our API to check for the duplicates in their repositories, to check for and to enrich or to fix issues in their repository. So the colleague from the Polytechnical University of Barcelona have already presented that in a webinar in the end of October. He presented it in a conference and also in the end of October, but it's only in Spanish. So I can put you in contact as a use case and you talk with him. But be aware that this is possible to do. So we are talking about the duplicate publications, and I think Dimitris is also providing some more information about
the
related statistics.
The user statistics, you cannot, for now, you cannot collect all this information with one single request, but you can try. You can try to use our API, the one that I mentioned above, and you can check for an item there. You will provide the DOI, and you will see all this information that's available for that DOI. DOI.
Ah, yes. Yes, and if it does not have a DOI, but a handle or other identifier?
I think we covered DOIs, OIP mates, I think, identifiers. Don't remember. I think if you check the API, we will find information what can be used as input. Or you can contact directly and check this together.
Yes, and can you put the API or the link to the API documentations in the chat?
Okay.
Thanks.
You put information in this document, but also we can exchange an email, and if needed, we can put you in contact with other persons. But the API is up to date, and you can try to test it. And
good, thank you. Super.
And for Jordan, the answer I was not. I didn't read before, so what we have is just currently what we have is just the results that we don't have a way to extract for to CSV the results of the reports, so you can see the results per item. You can check the views and downloads, but we don't have a way for you to download yet. We need to have it. It's in our priorities in the beginning of the service. I remember that we thought about that. Then there was several issues with the scalability of the users statistics service that we have faced it and solve it finally now. Dimitris, next step is to put this in production. So the all the results per query of this report, we need to put it in a way to click and download the CSV file. This is feasible and We just need to prepare it. I think I'm not seeing. So maybe we need to check in our next management meeting and provide some information here in the coming call, or we can. We also have the contact from Jordan. We can send information.
Yes,
this is the same for the broker events. Jordan, you are aware. So we only have a way to manually check that information and to manually see it in the dashboard. But for the broker, when we release this, when we put in production this new way of delivering the broker events, it's not only releasing the new way for the new workflow, subscribe, etc. It's also releasing a way to download the CSV file. So for the events, this will be in production soon. For the statistics, we need to decide. Maybe this is a topic for our next meeting, the management team, and then we can come up with in our roadmap with a specific timeline to deadline to have this delivered, program delivered. Thank you for your question and for the screenshots. Okay, perfect. So and it's 2:30. Thank you for your questions. And Dimitris, do you have anything else to add?
No, just to thank you all for your participation, and hope you see you joining the service.
Okay.
Be in touch.
Yes, for those that are already part of the service, I think we hope that you can now finally have the proper data and play with the information and have some up-to-date graphics and reports that will be useful. Then, now that we have the data presented in a correct way, then we will try to find and to have your requests about new ways to deliver this information. So we have already one request from Jordan, and that was trying to find the button to download the results of the reports. And for sure, we will have others. So this is a community effort that we need to find the good ways to deliver the service with proper quality of the data, but then create new features. So we will have the first call in January next year. I'm not sure when it is, it's in the first week. I know that the 1st of January is a Friday. So let's see if we can do it in the first week, in the first Wednesday of January, or in the second. We will put all the calls until the summer in the coming days here in this page. Okay, be aware of that. So we will put there, you can put in your calendar. So for sure, we'll put in the coming days from January to June all the calls. And if you are not a subscriber for the newsletter of OpenAIRE and the specific newsletter of Provide, just go to this web page, openair.eu newsletter Provide, and subscribe or check the previous. So we have several articles that with the guides about other services that you may are from your interest. So thank you very much. If you don't have any other questions, so let's close this meeting. If you want to put any other comment in that document that Andrea shared, we will check it during the day and tomorrow, and we will provide information. If you want to be contacted, just put your email there and we can contact you. Many thanks, and the recordings will be available after this call, and we put available the recordings in the presentation on the website. Bye bye all. Thank you for joining. It's always a pleasure to run these community calls. It's for the benefit of all. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.